if you know these things, happy are you if you do these. Grass withers, the flowers fade, thank you, Lord. It stands forever.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
From the 17th verse, I want to share a thought. Blessed indeed. I want to talk about blessed indeed.
All right.
Blessed indeed. Because in one sense, all of us have a measure of blessings this morning.
Amen.
How do you say that? Simply because we're here. And I can look at that and just kind of underline or highlight that. That's a common blessing.
Yeah.
And even more so, the commonality of the blessing is that the Lord allowed us to come in here. And then the Lord allowed many to stand on the outside of this place with no intent, with no burden for being in here. But if you look out, the sun is shining on them and on the just as well as the
unjust.
It's the same sun,
yeah.
Right? It's the same S-U-N, amen. But in light of that, do we have the same mindset as they have who are not in here?
Right now.
I'll take it a step further, as not only in here, but for those who are in Christ. Because when you're in Christ, there's a different mindset. I was about to say supposed to be, but I don't like that word supposed when it comes to the Word of God. Amen. Because I don't find much supposition in the Word of God.
Amen.
Either you are or you're not. Supposed to be a Christian. No, you don't supposed to be no Christian. You either are a Christian or you're not a Christian. I used to be saved. You used to be saved. You either saved now or you never were. That's what was uncomfortable for some folks. But all this time, you've been believing that you've been born again, blood washed, fire baptized, on your way to heaven in heaven. Oh, but God. Lord has a way, my brother and my sister, of enlightening us in a way that we maybe have not even thought about. Simply because we recognize that is He is the origin of our blessing. That's good news. To be blessed indeed. Listen, is not only to receive that, but to respond to that in a way that glorifies God and honors His presence in our life. Oh, yeah. Has that happened to you lately?
Yes, thank you, Lord.
And you say beyond a shadow of a doubt this morning, yes, Brother Pastor, I recognize that I'm blessed this morning, and I know that. I know I'm blessed.
Yes.
In one sense, I'm better than blessed.
Yes.
But I do know that I'm blessed.
Because yes.
I didn't have to be here.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
What the Lord brought me through this past week. Amen. I would have did y'all a favor just keeping my head on the pillow when time went back. And I'm looking at some of y'all right now. You still functioning in the old time. And I would have went back, but it don't matter. I'm still there. We recognize that, brothers and sisters, because it's important that we not get dismayed by this aspect of blessings in our life. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, some people will only venture out if they believe that there's a blessing attached to it. Some folks will only come to church if they feel like there's going to be some tangible blessing attached to that. Y'all know what I'm talking about. But you got to recognize that at the very inception of your relationship with the Lord, that's the blessing seed has already been planted. And really, there's not a whole lot we can do to add to what God has already sovereignly, amen, placed in our path for trusting Him. I'm not talking to anybody. In other words, if that would be the case, you'd be trying to put spiritual notches on your holy roly belt, amen, as to try to appease God, amen, as a way of saying, God, look, I'm better than the other. Now I need a higher level or depth of blessing because of my trekking with you right now. And I say to you this morning, brothers and sisters, that you can reduce God to a level, amen, of that type of relationship. Why? Because God is greater than that. Oh, yes, He is. Amen. There's a meta narrative involved in the whole Bible. Regardless of what we read on the surface, God is speaking to us on a much deeper level. Why? Because God is deep. He's not shallow. Yeah. Huh? Yeah. God, yeah, the very essence of the length, breadth, and width of His isness is beyond our comprehension. All we can do is sit at His feet and say, Lord, I'm just thankful to be called your child. I've been called a lot of things in my life. Amen. But none can exceed being called a child of God. Help me in here this morning. Yeah. Amen. Don't you dare get accustomed to being called, amen, any and every and all type of thing outside of what, amen, was on your birth certificate. Let alone what has happened on your new birthday since you met the Lord. Huh? Oh, y'all ain't with me. Oh, yeah, I'm telling you, the miraculous has made itself known in our lives. Well, what am I really saying here briefly? Listen, there's an application that we must recognize when it comes to service and humility. Amen. And it's something that you just can't continue to fake. Amen. It's got to become a part of your new relationship with Him. I don't know about you, if y'all get tired of acting. Amen. It's amazing. Folk that have no aspiration to go to Hollywood are some of the best actors on Sunday morning when it comes to the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the one next to you. What it reminds us and outlines here this morning, that John reminds us in no uncertain terms, it's important, my brother and my sister, that you recognize, listen, that you recognize what humility really looks like. What humbleness, the spirit behind the word, actually looks like and manifests itself in your particular body. Are y'all walking with me? That's why the narrative begins here. Jesus, it says that after He had washed their feet and had taken His garments off, the word says, and He sat down, notice, He sat down and began actually to teach them on, first of all, a cognitive level. What He said? He said, know ye what I have done unto you. In other words, brothers and sisters, you've got to recognize when you're talking about service and humility, it is inclusive of all that there is to you. Are y'all with me in here? Otherwise, you're just going through rote ritual. Amen. And religion. I had somebody tell me one time, said, why y'all do all them rituals around the church? And I said to them, I said, don't you have rituals in your life. Amen. You ritually go to work. Amen. Amen. And you, amen, you ritually go to the liquor store on Friday? Y'all didn't say nothing. You ritually go to happy hour? You got rituals. Amen. You got rituals. You ritually go to the tobacco store and buy smokes? And, amen. All that is rituals in every aspect of your being. Amen. But you don't consider it like that only when it comes to the house of work. Yeah, what is he saying? He's saying something, first of all, about the dynamics of humility. And that's important because he said, you call me. Listen to what he said. You call me Master and Lord, and you're right about this.
You're right about
it. Because I am. Huh? Now you be quick to run by the I am statement. But it goes way back to the backside of the desert in Exodus chapter 3. The mysterious tetragram, I am. Then it's transferred over into the New Testament. We got seven I am statements. And the power and the sublimity of God is behind every one of them. I am the goat. What you knocking for? I'm the goat. Why you thirsty? I'm the water that you need. Why you bumping and groping in the darkness? I'm the light of the world. Why you walking around spiritually hungry? I am the bread of life. Why you thirsty for the wrong thing? When I am the living water. Bring it up from all eternity. You take a drink from me, you'll never get thirsty. Some folk in the church are so dry and dusty, if you pat them on the back, dust will fly everywhere. You don't understand what it means to be, have your thirst quenched by the Lord. I said I wasn't going to be long. I got to close. We're talking about the dynamics of humility. Huh? This is important. The dynamics of humility, listen, it ought to be contagious.
Yes,
huh? Not just be something that's exemplified or practiced on the first Sunday of every month. Y'all ain't saying that.
You right.
I see the Lord with all them folk, them disciples, amen, gathered around that U-shaped table with him. He knew the character of every one of them. That's why he told them at the Last Supper, listen, one of you going to betray me. Huh? And they all began to, amen, get all anxious within themselves, got all in their feelings and said, I wonder who he talking about. I wonder, is it me? Is it John? Is it Peter? Is it Bartholomew? Who is it? Could it be me? Yeah. But you don't frown too hard on them. Amen. And some of us need to ask ourselves this morning that who it is that would betray him. Lord, is it I? Don't look at your neighbor now. No, Lord, is it I? Could I betray him? Yeah. All of them had that bit in their character that would manifest itself, amen, in the worst kind of way. Huh? And if you're not operating in the dynamic of humility, my brother, my sister, you and I can be some of the worst folk who ever want to come in country. And I don't care what you got on first Sunday, black, white, or polka dot, it don't matter. If you're not bent toward what the word is teaching in the spirit of humility, you're just going through the motion. Are y'all with me right there? Now, I don't want y'all to get me wrong. Now, I come out of a church denomination to where they literally, actually practice the washing of the saints' feet. We did that. Amen. I learned a lot in that church. A lot of my formation and my spiritual formation and theology was formed in that church, in the Primitive Baptist Church. Amen. We literally had annually a service of humility. Amen.